Hello students, in this video we are going to learn a new topic from carbonyl compounds. Till now we have learned the chemical properties of aldehydes and ketones. Now let us see how to differentiate aldehydes and ketones. So this goes under the subheading methods to distinguish between aldehydes and ketones. This is also called as reducing properties of aldehydes. Okay. So under this first one, we have silver mirror test. This can also be called as Tollens test. Okay. First one, silver mirror or Tollens test. What is this Tollens test? See, look here. When aldehydes are heated with Tollens reagent. What is Tollens reagent, students? Ammonical AgNO3, that means AgNO3 is silver nitrate plus ammonium hydroxide NH4OH. Together we call it as ammonical silver nitrate. Okay, what is Tollens reagent? Ammonical silver nitrate. So when aldehydes are treated with this ammonical silver nitrate, a silver mirror is formed on the inner walls of the test tube. Okay. So these tests will be performing in the laboratory, that is organic lab. Fine. So there while doing, you can observe this silver mirror forming on the inner walls of the test tube. Okay. So what is the reason for this silver mirror? Aldehydes, what they do, they reduce silver oxide into metallic silver. So this metallic silver deposits on the walls of the test tube, which we say it is responsible for silver mirror. Hope you understood this, right? Now the reaction, we write it like this: RCHO, general formula of aldehydes, plus silver oxide. This is coming from ammonical AgNO3, gives rise to RCOOH plus 2Ag, that is silver oxide is being reduced to silver. Okay, so RCOOH is oxidized and Ag2O is reduced to Ag. And you should notice one thing, ketones do not respond to this test. So this is the way we differentiate aldehydes and ketones. Okay, I will show you the reaction here. So ammonical silver nitrate means AgNO3 plus NH4OH, we get AgOH plus NH4NO3, silver hydroxide. Okay, so two molecules of AgOH gives rise to Ag2O plus H2O. Okay, so this is ammonical silver nitrate, that means Tollens reagent. So from these two we are getting silver oxide. Okay, therefore when aldehydes are treated with Tollens reagent, so what is coming from Tollens reagent? Silver oxide, that is Ag2O. Okay, so we get RCOOH plus 2Ag. So this is responsible for silver mirror. Okay, next. Second one is Fehling's test. What is Fehling's test? Fehling's test is nothing but when aldehydes are heated with Fehling's solution, red precipitate is formed. Okay, what is forming? When aldehydes are treated with Fehling's solution, red precipitate is being formed. This is due to the reduction of copper oxide or cupric oxide, which in which the Cu+2 ions possess blue color. So this is being reduced into cuprous oxide, which has a red color. Okay, so copper oxide in which Cu+2 ions are reduced to Cu+1 ions. Okay, therefore when aldehydes are treated with Fehling solution, red precipitate is being formed. Look at the reaction: RCHO, aldehyde, plus 2CuO, that is copper oxide. Here I have written blue color of copper ions. Okay, so this will be in the form of in the color blue. And when it is heated with the aldehyde, it is changing into cuprous oxide. Look at the oxidation state. Here Cu has plus 2 oxidation state. Here Cu2O means Cu has plus 1 oxidation state. That's the meaning. It is being reduced to cuprous oxide. Whereas its color is red color. So many textbooks you find as reddish brown. So I have written it as red color precipitate plus RCOOH. Okay. So actually, what is Fehling's solution? You might be getting a doubt. Fehling's reagent is a mixture of two reagents, Fehling's A and Fehling's B. So Fehling's A, students, it is copper sulfate pentahydrate. We call it as aqueous solution of CuSO4. So CuSO4 5H2O, which has blue color. Okay. Next, Fehling's B is a clear liquid. Okay, so it has sodium, potassium, tartrate plus a strong base, that is NaOH. So just I have given the structure also for your understanding or information. So C, C, COOK, COOA, Na. So sodium, potassium, tartrate. Okay, it can also be called as salt of Rochelle or Rochelle salt. So when these two are mixed, okay, in the laboratory we'll be finding Fehling's reagent, not like Fehling's A and Fehling's B. These two will be mixed up together and it will be given as Fehling's reagent. So when these two are mixed up, we get a dark or deep blue complex of Cu plus 2 ions. Okay, so I have made it very easy in the reaction, but many textbooks you will be finding this is a bis tartrate complex of Cu plus 2 ions. Okay, so you can just write simply as I have given you in the reaction. Okay, this is the actual thing which happens. Okay, and the third test to differentiate between aldehydes and ketones is Schiff's test. Spelling S-C-H-I-F-F. Schiff's test. What is Schiff's reagent? Reduced form of para-rosanilin is called Schiff's reagent. Okay, what is Schiff's reagent, ma? Reduced form of para-rosanilin is called Schiff's reagent. Okay, when aldehydes are treated with Schiff's reagent, they form or they give pink color, from which we say that the compound given to us has aldehydic functional group. Whereas ketones do not respond to this test. That is the third one. Next, fourth one, oxidation. Aldehydes on oxidation with alkaline KMnO4 gives carboxylic acids. This we have already learned in the properties. Having same number of carbon atoms, whereas ketones give carboxylic acids having less number of carbon atoms. I am writing the reactions here. CH3, CHO. On oxidation in the presence of alkaline KMnO4 gives CH3COOH, whereas ketones CH3 on oxidation gives CH3COOH plus HCOOH. So this already we have learned in the previous videos. Okay. And one more thing, students, just for your information, I am writing the reactions of aldehydes with Fehling's reagent, just to have a glance over here. Copper sulfate plus 2NaOH. So this is in Fehling's A, this is in Fehling's B, gives rise to CuOH twice plus Na2SO4, copper hydroxide. This copper hydroxide dissociates into CuO plus H2O. Okay, this is copper oxide in which Cu plus 2 ions have blue color. So when aldehyde is treated with this copper oxide, RCOOH plus Cu2O. This is cuprous oxide, which is in red color. Okay, so if you want, you can note down these reactions also. Fine. Okay, so we have learned 4 tests to distinguish aldehydes and ketones. First one is silver mirror test, second one Fehling's test, and third one Schiff's test, and fourth one is oxidation. Okay, so learn, read well and learn well. Thank you.